cold strawberry monster. Cheers, y'all. That's good. Fuck! It exploded! And it is everywhere on my floor. I'm gonna put the rest of this in this cup. Don't worry, it's orange Fanta, not piss. I don't know why someone's piss would be this orange. Okay. Not a great start, but you know what? Maybe that was a sign from the universe saying that if I continue to drink that monster, I would have had some really bad effects to it. So, you know what? That's fine. Also, don't mind me just getting chill as fuck. Okay, comfy. Comfy cozy. Oh, we're back at the splooge place. That sucks. Okay. I want to go get these two. I don't remember if there's anything down there. I'm gonna go check. Oh yeah, so I can't go check. Yes, Cheshire.
Steady now. Gather your nerve. Jump to the first vent, then the next, and ride the currents up.
This took an alarming amount of time, so I must speed run this.
I don't know if I should go there, or like, try to go up here. Okay.
Round two.
To see with the smell. Okay, jump, Alice. Good job. I don't know if I should. Yeah, I'll just use the pepper grinder. I'm scared that I'm gonna fall off if I get a warp over here. Go to this side. Finally! Hello, computadora. I don't see how to get over there. Is this like open? Hello! Look at this jump though. Oh my god, I'm dumb. I'm not dumb, it takes me a little while to process things, okay? I'm not dumb.
They say a cat has 9 lives, Alice. I hope you have as many.
Seeing as how I play this game, you can definitely tell that I have multiple lives. Probably more lives than a cat. So far, this is pretty chill. Pretty chill. Oh, these motherfuckers. Okay, well, I thought it could be a lot better because I have the controller. Oh, you mother! Don't you touch me! Don't you touch me! Don't you fucking touch me! I don't know, I forgot how to dodge! Dodge, girl, dodge! Okay, shrink! Oh god. Don't mind me. Oh, what the hell? That's so rude. Oh god. That's so rude.
Thank you.
y'all can see her hair. I love her hair. I love games where they show the way the hair moves. Like, this is... Oh, what the hell? Oh, okay. That's so fucked up. Okay, gonna speed run this because y'all know how long this shit takes me. Okay. I was holding my fucking breath. Is there anybody else trying to fucking kill me? No? Okay. God damn. Well, I'm definitely have like sort of like a mental plan of what to do. I know that with the teapots, I just need to shoot them with my pepper grinder in the eye. And always stay focused on the target. Always keep your eyes on the prize. Yeah, this would have been real helpful last time. What the fuck? Oh, I didn't see you, little puppy. Why the fuck do you always need to sneak up on me? It's so fucking rude. Wherever the... Oh, okay. Guess I was not supposed to go over there. Actually, do you know where to go? Oh, okay. Do I go back? Retreat. I don't know where to go. Oh, okay. I see that. Ooh, I'm scared. Okay. That was a cool backwards look back. What is that? Is that a motherfucker? Do I see a motherfucker? Okay, that's just a random thing.
Your presence here is unwelcome. We have a mission to complete, and you are an intolerable annoyance. Some like it hot, but no one likes it this hot.
Well, no. Seems very uncomfortable to have it that hot, even for you, Mouse. Why would you do this to yourself, Mouse? Oh, I see you. But I am getting it. Okay, thank you. See, I told y'all there was something on the line. Okay, perfect. They jump.
Y'all know the drill.
Okay, so I was smooth-minded and I didn't check to see if I had my video saved onto my iPad before deleting my previous clips for this gameplay. So there is gonna be no video of me playing this gameplay. So please enjoy this gameplay of me and a picture, I guess. I'll put a picture so y'all can look at my face. I hope that suits your fancy. Yeah. Killing this little poopy. The little poopies are cute, but they're fucking annoying. Like, come on, really? That's your only party trick? Also, I'm low-key happy that I did fuck it up because the audio, the previous audio was so bad. Like, you heard the Golden Girls, like, on full blast. Oh, wait, hold on. The bitch is gonna talk.
I've got the arms you need. Well, strictly speaking, the hatter needs them. Well, it really doesn't matter. I'm going to crush you.
I really doubt that Pipsqueak can crush me, but I'd like to see you try. I like to see you try, bitch. Anyways, yeah, so I thought I would talk about some life updates because, as y'all can tell, the Alice gameplay has been very sparse and in between, and I'm mainly blaming it on going back to college, but there has been some times where I definitely could have worked on it on my off days, but I've been feeling a little stressed about going back to school because it's different from before when I was doing college and it was all online. Now it's like fully in person, but like some of the assignments I have to do online. But yeah, I've actually been really liking going on campus. It's been nice to walk around more. I feel like I could, you know, I have more energy to do things, which is nice. I like that part. It is a little overwhelming when I am on campus though, because I'm someone that gets very scared of like, oh, is this person looking at me? Is this person not looking at me? Like, whatever the fuck. Like, overthinking every single thing, and sometimes I just hold my breath as I'm walking because, like, I don't know. I have a weird thing of holding my breath, and I don't realize that I'm holding my breath until, like, I take a long, like, exhale, and I'm like, oh, fuck, that felt good. Just to breathe. But yeah, I'll give y'all some updates about my life so far. So I don't know if I said this or not, but okay, I'm gonna go a little bit further back of college. But for a while, I was taking care of my mom because she had gotten valley fever. So I was changing her dressings because they had to take out an abscess and test it to see what it was. And then they figured out it was valley fever. So I have been changing her dressings and stuff and taking her to her doctor's appointments. And then my mom had finally like pushed me to go back to college, and I was really hesitant at first and I felt regret signing up for a college, but now I'm very happy that she made me do it. And I really do like going to college because I like learning things. Like, I didn't really like learning things in high school, like, because it was just so boring. And in college, like, there's this one professor that teaches history, and he tells it in such a way that is so interesting. Like, you can tell that he really loves the subject, and he knows, like, a lot of, I don't know, like, learning about history is, like, kind of like learning about juicy gossip about the olden times. Like, I've learned so many different things about the history of the U.S. that I'm like, what the fuck? That is, like, very interesting. So, well, one of my things, like, I kind of knew that this was a thing, but one of the things that I find very interesting was that in the beginning of the U.S., we had indentured servants, and usually poor people or women and children that wanted like a better life than England would pay to go on a boat, and then so that they could eventually become indentured servants to someone, which is where you work on a farm for a certain amount of time, and then once that time is done, you're able to be free in America. So a lot of people would do that, but on the boat to come to America was like so dangerous. Like, a lot of, like, in one of the passages it said that people had gotten like lice, sickness, vomiting, just like a whole bunch of different like awful things that was happening. And it was like, oh my god. Our ancestors, like, just thinking about the shit that our ancestors had to deal with back then to, like, experience the life that we live now. It's just so interesting and cool. And it makes me have a lot of appreciation for the past and what past generations have dealt with for me to get here. And as I sit in my room, I am looking at my dolls and I'm like, ooh, I don't know if I would survive back then because, like, I'm just a little baby. Like, I like to collect dolls and I like to watch cartoons and, you know, play Alice Madness Returns to Wonderland. And I don't know. It's just so different. Like, so weird how people have, like, paved the way for us. I don't know. I just find it so cool and interesting. And I recently got into contact with one of my older ancestors, I guess you could say. I think he's my great uncle. And he was telling me about how our family came to be, of how they immigrated and then they would move from farm to farm with the different crops and how they were abused from immigration and stuff. And it's like, oh my god, I did not experience half of the shit that they've experienced. And I don't know, I just think it's really cool. But yeah, I originally went to, or am going to college because I wanted to become a librarian. But as I've been thinking, I have more of a fixation on death. So I've been thinking about becoming a mortician. I really love learning about death. A couple of months ago, I was watching a whole bunch of near-death experience videos where they were talking about what it was like for them when they died and why they came back or all that different kind of stuff. And it was really comforting for me because I had been so scared of death. And I don't know, it just brought me a lot of peace and I'm no longer scared of death. It's fine for me. I'm gonna hold this thought for now because the rat bitch is gonna fucking do her spiel again.
Temporary setback, a minor hindrance, a trivial impediment. I'll just move along. I'll deal with you later, Alice. You'll never stop our grand plan.
Bitch, what the fuck are you talking about? I'm just chilling. But yeah, there's my favorite YouTuber. She's like a mortician. Her name is Caitlin Doherty, and she posts like a lot of different things about being a mortician and just talking about being accepting of death and how it's not a scary thing. And she also talks about sustainable funeral services such as alkaline. There's like an alkaline process where it's like they describe it as like a spa for the deceased where they put your body in like really hot water or alkaline water and then it dissolves your flesh. It leaves you with bones and then they pulverize your bones and then it'll kind of be like a cremation but just without the fire, which is more eco-friendly because if you were to have a cremation then you would put a lot of fumes into the air, which is, you know, bad for the environment. Obviously, if you choose to do that, no hate or whatever. It's just not everyone has the knowledge of what's going on. Also, hold on.
Mobility will make a nice change. Expect no thanks until I'm completely reconstructed. No resting on laurels, chiffoniers, chaise lounges, Ming folding chairs, stools.
I literally have no idea what the fuck he's talking about. Like, could you not speak in a riddle for once in your life, Hatter? Like, what the fuck? Anyways, talking about my hyperfixation on the different ways of death, you can also have like a natural burial where they put you in a shroud. I think it's called a shroud. And, you know, just in no coffin, just your body in the shroud. And, you know, you just let the earth consume you. And Caitlin explains it as just like a way of giving back to the earth. You know, the earth gives you so much life that it's only natural to give your life to the earth and help it, you know, grow. There's also ways of turning your body or remains into compost, which I think is also really cool. I think that's another cool option that you can do, and another way to give back to the earth. I think I would either want to be turned into compost or just be buried underneath a tree. And there is actually like this thing where if you're buried underneath a tree, you can see that the roots grow into the shape of you. And I think that's really cool. I'm not 100% sure on that. I just saw a comment of someone saying that. I need to do more research on it. But I checked out a book at the library. There's a book up. Okay, this is what really sparked my, like, okay, maybe this is a sign from the universe that I need to become a mortician. Because when I was, my first day at college, I went to the library. I think it was the second day. But I went to the library, and I was looking at all the different books, and I saw something that caught my eye, and it was the death book. It's right next to me. It's called Death, The Scientific Facts to Help Us Understand It Better by Richard Belleville, PhD, and Dennis Gengrass, PhD. It's been really interesting reading so far. Hold on, I'll read some of the quotes that I've pulled out of it because I really like them. Here's a quote that I thought was kind of interesting to think about is, to give meaning to life is often important to find meaning in death. Alice looks so cute in the little roller coaster. That's so cute. Also, Cheshire is going to talk soon, so hold on.
The dimensions of this desolate tract are unknown to all but the inhabitants.
Yeah, I mean, I assume so. They live there. I don't live here. I wouldn't know what their situation is. Don't know what you were trying to get with that, but all right, Cheshire. Okay. Anyways. Another quote or reading that I liked was, death is not solely physical, it is above all the death of a person. And in this section they were talking about how, what is death? Like, how do you define death? Is death when you die, like physically? Or is death when your brain dies? Because a lot of people, or some people with brain damage, they're not the same person. They're not there, but their body is still there. Their body is still beating and functioning, but the brain is not. And how do you really define when someone is dead? And I really do agree with that death is not only when your heart and brain stop, it is when you stop. And I don't know, I think it's just something very interesting to learn about or think about.
Industry thrives on suffering, obsolescence, and ruination. It's made the East End into a privy. Consider a simple farm life in Australia, perhaps. We might liquidate what remains of your inheritance.
I would love to move to Australia and live a simple farm life. I think that would be very lovely. I actually have been thinking for a while about living the simple farm life and having a pie in the windowsill. That used to be a running joke in my family that I would have a pie in the windowsill, but yeah, hopefully in the future I could manifest that and have a simple little life. But anyways, talking about death again, I want to give my thoughts on it. I think you can experience many different deaths in your life, like death of a personality, death of the person you once were, you know. I think it's kind of like a snake shedding its skin, you know. You're shedding a different part of you and to become something new. I don't really know how to explain it, but that's how my brain thinks of death. Anyways, I can probably talk about death forever and ever, and I don't know if y'all want to hear me talk about that forever and ever. So anyways, I have really struggled with this part. Like, this part took me so long, so as y'all can probably tell with the time lapse, I fucked up so many different times, so I'm glad the audio failed because this is perfect for me. Hopefully y'all don't get seasick. I am getting a little seasick from this gameplay. Another update on my life, I guess you could say, is that I've been trying to work on my social skills. So I've been trying to talk to different people in my class. Like, I don't know, just trying not to mask as much as I did in the past. And still to this day, I do mask a lot. Not as much as I have been, but it's actually been nice because I feel like I connect to people a lot more, and I don't know, I just like to see people just in their natural selves. Like, I don't know, it's like kind of like unlocking like a secret, like, I don't know. So recently I went to goth night with my friends, and that was super fun. I fucking love this goth night. Me and my friends, we played Uno with my brother, his boyfriend, and my friends. And it was taking forever because we kept shuffling the hands, but yeah. So one of my friends technically won because we all forfeited and he didn't, but yeah, that was fun playing Uno. And then there was like different like art vendors or like just vendors outside, and there was like this Mexican food. So me and my friend, we got Mexican food, or he got Mexican food, and I tried a bite of his burrito, and it was so fucking good. Ugh, I love it. It was a nice night. I really love dancing. I oftentimes dance alone in my room. Whenever I hear when I hear a song that I like, it has a good beat or rhythm, I just like, I don't know, something in my body, in my heart, my soul, I just need a fucking dance. Like, ugh. I don't know, I get really excited whenever I dance, and it's really relieving. It helps me get rid of some of the negative energy or just like pent up energy that I have, and just put it towards just moving my body and just feeling the music, listening to the music. It's really nice. It's really fun. I love it. And I like seeing the different dance moves that other people had, you know, just like seeing how different friend groups interacted with each other and dance, seeing how older goth people dance, and like, I don't know, everyone has their own unique style of having fun and dancing, and it was just really cool. And everyone there had such a cool-ass outfit. Like, there's people with like big-ass goth boots. It's like, fuck, I wish I could stand in platforms for a long time. I have tried so many times to like walk in platforms and not have my feet be fucked up, but it always happens. Like, my feet get so sore from walking on like platforms. I don't know if I am buying the wrong ones, or I just need to break them in, or I just need to just get used to the pain. I don't know. But yeah, I really wish I could wear platforms for a long time. I was really anxious about going to this goth night. I don't, like, whenever I go to certain things that I haven't gone to in a while, I get really anxious and nervous. But I was really glad that I went, and I had a lot of fun. So yeah, 10 out of 10, recommend y'all going to a goth night if you like goth music and looking at people's outfits. It was really cool and interesting to see how people dressed up and stuff. Anyways, I'm gonna stop yapping now. I've been yapping for a very long time, and I don't know if y'all want to hear me yap for, I don't know how many long I'm gonna yap for, but I will just let the gameplay play, and I will see y'all in the next video. Thank you for continuing to support me and watching these videos. It means a lot to me. I oftentimes get down on myself for not, I don't know, posting enough or not getting enough views. And I've just realized that, like, this is for fun. This shouldn't be about how many views I get or how many likes I get. This is just something that I really like doing. So, yeah, I hope you all enjoy the rest of this video. Maybe I'll check back in once it's done, or give commentary whenever those fuck-ass villains are talking.
insects eat their young, and they have much to teach us, alive or dead.
Rewarded with pain! I told you to cease and desist, but my warning goes unheeded. So without regret, you're about to feel like a lobster who's being tossed into the boiling pot!
Thank you.
the meanest trifle. I'll be leaving now. Never catch me. Don't even try.
Finish my work and you're complete, Hatter. Now, what about this damnable train?
I feel like a new man, or whatever I am. I feel like an unsprung spring, like an uncorroded gear, like an untarnished bit of metal that sticks in your eye!
Answer me, Hatter. I'm suffering, and changes here are a cause, or they're a reflection, or the effect. What's going on? What are the new rules?
The law is just a whispered away, a way home to wonder who knows how to measure rules with a ruler. Cruel rules.
Idiot. I should have left you in bits. Come, the least you can do is help me discover what's going on.